to break. Our very own Dan Graziano and Jordan Ronan reporting that Eli Manning will officially retire on Friday at a press conference. And I think that Eli feels that he could still play, but he's kind of boxed in. He learned life as a backup quarterback was not something that he enjoyed. He said that when he got the starter's job back when Daniel Jones was out with the injury. He didn't like backing up. He thought it was miserable. And all he's ever done was start his entire career, all of a sudden, backing up. So when you look at the landscape of the NFL, where was Eli going to go to start? And he didn't want to come back to the Giants and back up Daniel Jones. And probably the Giants didn't want him hovering over Jones anyway, although he was a great influence on Jones. So it comes down to this. I think Eli made the choice that he was almost painted in the corner to make, because I think if you injected him with truth serum, he would tell you, I can still play. He does not think his skills have diminished. He has not been banged around and hurt like most quarterbacks. He has been an Iron Man, and now he becomes part of the great Giants legacy, two-time Super Bowl MVP, two-time Super Bowl champion, four-time Pro Bowl selection, seventh in NFL history, passing yards, seventh all-time with 366 TD passes, has that great streak of 210 straight games starting. The guy answered the bell all the time, finished with a record of 117-117 thanks to that win that he had when he was filling in for Jones. And Don, now the debate will start. Obviously, nobody will ever wear his number 10 again for the Giants. He did that number proud. He did the Giants proud. He's everything the Giants could have wanted. He represented the organization in a great way. And on the day when Derek Jeter's making the rounds here in New York as a new Hall of Famer, Eli Manning retires, and you wonder, is his ultimate landing spot going to be in Canton?
Yeah, I think it will. Because the only argument you can make is if you take those two championships away, you can't take those two championships away. Two-time Super Bowl MVP, consistently threw for 4,000 yards, longevity, never missed a game due to injury, missed just one game in his career because of the ill-fated decision to have Geno Smith start in Oakland. He has been an amazing player, for the most part, kept his nose clean. I know you got that controversy with the game-used helmets and stuff, but for the most part, he made the Giants proud. He made himself proud. Good guy. And I think he'll land in Canton. There's a couple of things at play here for trying to make a decision at the state he's in. Could he maybe try to hook up with another team, kind of wait out the summer, see if somebody gets hurt, see what plays out in New England, right? Let's say Brady decides to leave. Will the Patriots be looking for a quarterback? Would he get a chance to sign on with a team? Remember, he's a free agent, and I don't think the Giants have any appetite to bring him back. And certainly if they did, it would just be a mentor to Jones, who probably doesn't need that now that he's had a full season under his belt. But I think his oldest daughter's in school now. Does he want to, like, live in a hotel someplace when his family stays back in New Jersey? Does he want to uproot his family for a one stint here, one stint there kind of thing? So, yeah, I think he believes he can still play, but there's no guarantee of a starting job, no guarantee where that would be. So why would you want to uproot your family and basically live out of a suitcase just to be able to keep one more year alive when I think you've accomplished everything you set out to do in your career?
Yeah, I don't think he wants to retire. Again, that's through no knowledge that he gave me or I've heard from anybody. Just watching from the outside looking in, he thinks he could still play. He thought that he should have played this year. He understands the dynamics of getting a new quarterback in there. He can't play forever. But at the age of 38, and he sees Tom Brady playing at 42 at a very high level, and, you know, he's been banged up less than Tom Brady, and he probably still wants to do it. But I also believe that being a Giant, a lifetime Giant, really means something to him. And he knows, I could go somewhere else, maybe start, maybe have to win a job, and then I'm not going to be an all-time Giant. I'm going to be a Giant plus that one year.
But you're telling me that, let's say, Philip Rivers out of nowhere decided to retire tomorrow, and Brady re-signed with the Patriots, and the Los Angeles Charger job was open, and they offered him the starting job.
He's taking it.
He's taking that, I would think. But I think
know.
He realizes that that's not going to happen. What?
Also, just, I mean, wouldn't it be weird? He refused to be drafted by the San Diego Chargers, and all of a sudden he would end with the LA.
It would actually be kind of cool.
But the different regime, everything has changed.
Same ownership.
I'm just giving a hypothetical, Michael.
But let's just be clear.
I don't know.
He said a few weeks ago, when the season ended, multiple times, Eli made clear, I'm going to think about this. I'm going to let you know what I want to do. I want to play. I don't want to back up. If we all knew all those things, guys, the only thing that changed was that the landscape for quarterbacks became official. You know, his agents were able to check things out and go, Eli, there's nothing there for you, dude. And Eli, being the class act that he is, was like, I'm not going to force it and hang out till July. I'm done. And if you don't want me to be your starter, and I'll tell you the truth right now, as someone who's been critical of Eli, he can go. I think he could be a team that was set up and had pieces in place. I think Eli could still be a pretty viable starter. Would he be a top half in the league starter? I don't know about that. But he could be around the 18 to 20 mark in the league still. I still think he's capable of that.
Yeah, but
the
right
jobs
team.
Aren't there.
You know, you telling me he couldn't win some games for the Dallas Cowboys with a good offensive line, a running game, two big targets to throw the football to?
Bears.
You know, so...
I like the Bears for Eli.
I don't think as a quarterback during the course of the season, even as a backup, you're sitting there analyzing all the teams and finding a landing spot. He probably was focused on the game, focused on himself, and then when the season was over, he probably told his agent, make a couple of phone calls, see if there's any interest. Well, how long has it been now? Almost a month since their last game? They probably came back to him and said, Eli, right now, there are no nibbles. Something can happen, but you're talking about somebody having to get hurt in order for you to get a job. Do you want to do that, or do you want to just walk away? And he thought about it, and it just makes sense, right?
And he doesn't need the money. It was an amazing stat that I didn't realize. He's made more money in his career than any player in NFL history, more than his brother. Now, Brady plays this year. He will pass him. But Eli's certainly taken care of, and he's done a good job, and he's had, you know, obviously a lot of commercial endorsements and stuff like that. So I don't think money has anything to do with this. I think that being a lifetime Giant means something to him in a big way, and he didn't want to be backup anymore.
I think we do overrate that. I think in the moment it's awkward. It's awkward to see Michael Jordan as a Wizard. You know, it was awkward to see Namath as a Ram. But as history goes on, that just fades into the background, right?
But it is true because in a sense it's not. We always know that Joe Namath ended up a Ram. Johnny Unitas ended up a Charger. That's that, you know, it's always that caveat.
I guess.
It's not going to be a caveat with Eli. He was a Giant.
Right, but does it affect you being an all-time whatever? I mean, does it affect Namath being an all-time Jet?
No.